everyone. Hope everyone's doing well. Having a new thing that we're doing today. It is called On This Day in Wrestling, and I'm joined by Grog's voice. Hello, Grog's voice.
Hello, Tony.
Hello. How are we doing through this quarantine period?
Well, it does get very tedious, but I'm doing all right. Yourself?
Yeah, mate. Making the best of what we have to do during these times. But that's why we're doing this, yeah. To try and fill some time and give some other people's time filled as well. So, on this day in wrestling, we are now going to do predictions on a wrestling show that happened on this day that we filmed this. This is being filmed on the 10th of April. So we've gone back on the WWE Network to find an old school show, and we have found ECW Hardcore TV from April 10th, 1999, which we are going to watch and get drunk whilst watching, because we've got some drinking rules, and Groggo, if you would love to run through them.
Awfully kind, you sir.
Oh.
The rules are: one sip of the drink for any weapon used or manager interference.
Yeah.
Two sips for any theft of a finisher or tag team maneuver. Doesn't have to happen in a tag team match, but it has to be a proper tag team move.
Yes, yes.
Three sips for an oh my god by Joey Styles, as regularly occurs, somewhat. Yep. And or a Hall of Famer in WWE is prevalent.
Yep.
And drink for fire or wire.
Oh, yes.
Which constitutes the use of fire or barbed wire.
Which I think is perfect to down the mortar, so it'll be great. So, anyone wants to watch along with it, we'll be doing it. ECW Hardcore TV, April 10, 99. I'm ready to press play, because we're not together, you see, because of the quarantine. We have to try and sync them up well. Are you ready, Grogo?
I'm good, mate. Have you started the pay-per-view? I have.
No. We didn't do the 3, 2, 1, go.
Oh, sorry. I started it at the same time as started it. So, run again.
Right, so you, yes, go for 1 second, and as soon as you say go after one, I'm going to press play.
So I'm going to have to rewind. I've got 2 minutes and 17 seconds in.
It is, that's crazy. I'm just...
Right, 3, 2, 1, play. Expect lots of the Bloodstorm and Dawn Marie.
That is Dawn Marie looking lovely. He's wearing a WCW Jericho shirt.
He is, isn't he? I know they're good friends, aren't they, I think?
Well, they've got history. I'm going to crack open my drink. Carlsberg, what are you drinking tonight there, Grog?
Vodka and Monster.
Ooh. Well, there's nothing yet, but I'm going to have a cheeky swig just to get the thing going.
Say you were drinking Budweiser.
Carlsberg, me mate, Carlsberg.
Probably the worst beer as well for me, but
oh, I do like it.
Well, have a good night, mate.
Exactly. Cheering for Jericho right now.
What's a Jericho-holic?
Oh yes.
Of which I am one.
Oh yeah. Le Champion, not anymore, but. Oh dear. Why is Lance Storm out here?
I'm out here because Tommy Dreamer has been running his mouth.
Oh,
he's got it spot on with the synchronicity.
No, it does. It sounds pretty good.
Yeah.
Bang. Claiming that I'm on the gas.
Just like,
listening to my right, looking to my left, and the camera's
there. Yeah, I'm looking. The camera's on my left, but the TV's in front of me, so I'm sort of going back and forth because your voice is coming from the camera. So I look at it while I think I'm talking to you, you see, it's fine.
Another buzz.
Vile. Steroids? Oh, if one of the Hart family comes out, that's a definite Hall of Fame drink.
Yeah.
One of the most underrated wrestlers was Lance Storm.
That's something that a bunch of wannabe athletes coach potatoes
coming out. Oh, they scratched out TNT on the Jericho shirt.
Channel that was filmed, wasn't it? Yeah. Yeah. I am the
best built professional athlete this side of a negative drug test. And tonight,
I'm gonna prove it.
She's
what's
got
it?
Her bag.
In
it? She's got piss!
Oh.
A vial of pee. Yes.
The question
is,
see?
Is Tommy
Dreamer willing to do the same?
Yes.
That's it. That's the question.
We're
gonna have this angle either, don't you? No. You just get Gallows and Anderson backstage dressed as doctors. That's copyright infringement. That's someone else used to say that. Who's this? Oh, it's Tommy. You saw a video about what? I watched. Yeah, I watched that. It was on What Culture, wasn't it?
Yeah.
Yeah, some of them were like, I knew that, but then, yeah, it is pretty shocking, especially with Lacey Evans.
Yeah, she ain't gonna last long with that, but.
Oh, dude, it's totally buffered on me.
What was it?
Yeah, I'm at like 5 minutes 15. Where are you? It's fine, I've skipped ahead, I'm at 5:34.
You're currently 15 seconds ahead.
15 seconds ahead?
Yeah, just poured the drink on his face a moment.
Oh dear. Let me know when you get to 5 minutes 40.
Yeah, I'll let you know. We're nearly there. Now.
Alright. Sorry about that, people. For some reason, it likes to buffer.
It happens, doesn't it?
Yeah. Could just about hear an echo as well. Love it.
Yeah.
This was one of my favourite wrestling show intro tunes.
Yeah, along with my favourite nature of all time being shown as well.
Oh, dude, I just saw a weapon shot in that opening package. I hope you're drinking. We didn't specify if the opening promos would be a part of it, so we have. There's your shopping trolley.
Yeah, do we count video packages?
Yeah, definitely. That's it. And that one. Yeah, that's two more.
That's two more.
And another one. Another one.
Well, I might run out of drink during this promo.
The weapon rule was always going to be difficult in ECW. So thank Karina for that rule, I suppose.
Big Lambert's
house looks like
that before. Extreme. Isn't that a point we did make at the beginning, wasn't it? Neither of us have seen this show.
Is he gonna say it though? Oh look, D.O. Brown!
Yeah, he wasn't there then, was he?
EC Dub. It's good that we didn't do EC Dub as a bloody drink chant.
Yeah, doing the head shake and everything.
Hang on. Oh, I thought someone was coming out then. The camera really did weirdly pan across.
Just showing the rabid audience.
Yeah.
not just yet, mate.
Oh no, that's three. Oh, this is a Cyber Slam weekend show. Here we go. It's Ron Van Don. Is that a fucking WWE Winged Eagle belt? That TV title that he's wearing looks like a done over Winged Eagle WWE Championship belt for a split second.
His manager got another one of his belts, he got three belts.
Well, I'm assuming the other one's tag team belts. But underneath the lower of the two belts on his waist, I thought it was like a Winged Eagle WWE title belt that was like doodled over. Look, do you know what I mean?
It's a good looking belt, yeah. Less blue on it than the Winged Eagle.
Yeah, it's got ECW written on it, but it just looks like they've gone over one with, you know, a bit more gold and stuff. So he's a TV champion and tag team champion.
TV and tag.
I think he was the longest reigning TV champ ever.
Was he the last ECW champion?
I don't think he was ever ECW champion, the original ECW.
He was the last hardcore or European or two, most of them, wasn't he?
Yeah, but WWE don't recognise the European one.
But
they do include the hardcore belt, which had the exact same outcome.
Yeah, they like to mess around
with
stuff.
Yeah, it's
weird.
But yeah, mate, RVD smashed it in ECW.
Yeah, solid. Never the best of the microphone, but more than made up for in the ring.
Effin show.
Mr. Relax,
because he was always high.
Exactly, yeah.
Oh, so RVD's got a fight. Who's he against?
Who's this dude on the mic?
That's Bill Alfonso. That's his. He used to be a referee and then turned into a manager. He managed Taz and then Sabu and Rob Van Dam. Right, so we've got to get our predictions in now. Who's RVD against? I don't recognise the theme tunes.
It's going to be Taz needs to go against RVD.
Is it going to be? It is! It's Too Cold Scorpio from the Job Squad! Okay, well, who are you going for? Who's your pick?
RVD.
Do you know what? I'll make it interesting on the very first one. I'll go with Too Cold Scorpio.
Okay, dude.
But yeah, he was in the Job Squad when it first started. It was him, Al Snow, Hardcore Holly, and Blue Meanie.
Yeah, I knew the other three there, and Davey Richards was as well, wasn't he?
No, Gilbert was for a while.
I think in a blue world.
Oh, who's this?
Sabu.
He's getting held back by, that's Roadkill on the right. I don't recognise anyone else. Who? Is that, was that, oh sorry, that's ECW mate, it's Little Guido.
Yeah, Little Guido. Well, Italian.
Let's see. Well, we've got a good chance of manager interference here.
I'll have to refill my drinks.
Alright. 1-800 something something 8 something something 4-1. Complete guess. He just spat all over the ref.
9-1 at the end, I think.
Yeah. This should be a good match as well, to be fair.
Yeah, I wouldn't expect less from... Well, I don't know much about the Duke Girls score, but there, we did watch one earlier with the
Mystic. Also known as Flash Funk.
Yeah, Mr. Boogie. Come on!
Welcome back. So this must be he's just come back.
Yeah.
Oh, it's a title match. Nice. I want to change my pick to Rob Van Dam.
You're allowed to, the bell hasn't rung yet.
I'm going to, because I didn't realise this was a championship match.
Yeah.
And trying to remember my history, I don't think RVD lost this belt to Too Cold Scorpio. And if he wins this match now, I've done myself right up.
Yeah, this is for the...
I think it's for the TV title, because they introduced Too Cold as the challenger, so... So,
you know more about the reign of his belt than me, and I don't recall too much about it as a holder.
Just a bit of RVD signal there. Heyman! Who's that in the background dressed up like a heart brother?
Is that Billy Kidd on the back right?
Is that what I was thinking? But he's dressed up in like Heart Foundation clobber, it looks like. Right, so
RVD, yeah?
Yeah.
Right.
I was going to go Too Cold Scorpio, but I didn't realise it was going to be a title match.
That's fair enough. Before the bell rings, you're all right to change the finish arm to see
what. Rah. Then. Damn.
I hope we get far all right.
Okay, was that a referee? Was that a manager interference there, getting up on the apron? Is he gone? I keep saying ref because he used to be one. Was that a manager interference when he gets on the rope and distracts the ref?
Nah, I think it's
got to
be physical somewhat.
Yeah. Okay. So if he grabs an arm or a leg or something. Fair dues, fair dues. Good start to the match, though. Say maybe around there. Depends if there's, because there are a few balconies, I think.
Yeah.
So yeah, a couple of thousand could be. You never know.
It's weird seeing what I saw one guy in the audience there with a phone looking at the crowd. You get that like half the audience these days. There's another guy there. That's a camera though, isn't it?
Yeah.
Different times.
Back in day.
Back in day.
Who's
got the most lethal kicks in history, do you think? Is that there with X-Pan? X will be up there, isn't it?
Yeah, I think so.
Anyone else? Plenty of others.
Well, yeah, how about Too Cold Scorpio right now? You can give it a kick. But yeah, in terms of Matt Riddle's probably the most recent that loves a kick.
I guess I'm thinking of the kind of classic kick RVD and X-Pac do with the back swirling round kind of back kick.
Sabu's just going mental. Why is he doing a Randy Orton pose? Oh!
Why did I not put 2 pounds more here at the kick to Gashi when he threw them?
What a... That was a dirty kick to the bush.
Yeah. What's that with the bush chin? You know?
What's his special move?
Nah, what's that with the bush chin?
Oh, I don't know. Yeah, I spotted it. I don't know, maybe... Well, to be fair, you know what he's like. He probably rolled around in barbed wire and punctured the bloody thing.
Yeah, doesn't count as a wire, though.
Oh, dear. I mean, it's not much happening so far with the drinking rules, but...
No, it's quite a lot of cutbacks in the back, isn't it?
Yeah. What's he going for here? Nice.
Like Ryback's finisher.
Yeah, that was slightly shell-shockish, wasn't it?
Shell-shock, that's it.
Is that Cyrus?
That looks like Lewis Hamilton in the back left.
Wait a minute! What the...
What happened there?
What happened there?
He got out there quickly, didn't he?
Oh, dude, we got a... That's a weapon shot. Put for a fucking table. So if anyone watching this and not watching along, we were shown Sabu trying to get away from everyone backstage again. It then cut to black for what I assume was an advert, and then when it came back, Sabu was flying over the top rope and put 2 Cold Scorpio for a table outside. That was literally everything we got to see.
Springboard seated table spot to the outside.
Yeah. So, like, took a step
F
off
you
the.
On his arm, man.
F you on his shirt. Yeah. Well spotted.
Many
years pre-John Cena. Does that apron say blood and guts?
It certainly
says
blood, yeah, it might
do
actually.
It does. Right. Oh, maybe that's inspiration for AEW's version of the War Games. That could be it, mate. That could be it.
Nah.
Nah, you were right, sir.
Didn't feel it. So this is RVD in his pomp, isn't it? From anywhere up to about 2002, 2003.
Yeah, I think this is like just before he steps into his prime, but he was on form. See, look, low blow, does that count as a weapon shot because it would be illegal?
Nah.
Fair enough. Powerbomb!
Not that we're calling off the flyer.
Kick out. I switched, I shit myself. To be fair, this is a bloody good match as well.
Yeah, good start.
Hold up, here we go. Here we go. That's a blatant drink. What's that? Is that one?
Yeah. Here we go, number one.
Hang on, this is two then. This is three.
Terminator. Those can be vicious.
So this is three. Because that's a weapon. So that's two. Weapon shot and manager interference. That's why we're going with the shows that don't last an hour.
Yeah. Not that I wasn't before I started either.
So, yeah, no, we were drinking earlier, which was helpful. Oh, that's game.
Yeah, done.
There it is. And I'll tell you now, I'm glad I switched, but
yeah.
What a bloody good match that was.
Excellent.
Yeah. Lucky I got the switching in time there. That was... I wouldn't... Honestly would have picked RVD if I knew it was a title match. I say that.
Yeah.
I believe that I honestly would have.
You weren't willing to take the gamble with knowing it was a title match. That makes sense, because any knowledge that you're taught in through the belt, if you don't recognise the name, you go for it.
Exactly.
Like in the lineage.
Yeah. But fair play, I would recommend. I'm glad that we've watched it and we've done it by the day that we're watching these things on, because, like, why else would you ever randomly watch April 10, 1999 of ECW? That was a good match for the TV title.
Well, definitely, yeah, it only came about because I randomly brought up on a pilot episode earlier. I've been right here with Justin Crowley. Test one, it happened to land on the next day.
Yeah, no, it makes sense though, it's a great idea.
Yeah.
But is, there we go, just incredible.
And nobody likes me, but I tried to recall it.
Oh,
as he goes. Oh, so bad.
I give you everything I ever wanted, and I'll never get that back. I know you hate expect, but you ain't gonna look at me like that. Bit of X Factor. Also known as, here's a bit of trivia for you that some people might not know, I think a lot of them will. Aldo Montoya.
Yeah, yeah.
The Portuguese Man O' War. That was just incredible.
His red and green trunks and his mask.
Yep.
Yeah.
It's the only way they could hide the fact that he wasn't from Portugal. But he was, apparently, he was like proper tight with the clique. That's why he was in X Factor with X-Pac, because he was proper mates with a lot of the clique.
What about Albert, was he? Mr. Bloom?
Mr. Blue?
Mr. Bloom?
No, I'm not sure. I think he was probably there just because, you know, he's a good company guy and he could keep them two in check.
Steady hand and also...
And he's a lump of a lad. But that's Shane Douglas. Yeah. Is he doing a Randy Savage? Oh, yeah. I'll be the franchise of the WCW, ECW, whoever it is, bro.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah.
I was going to tell you,
I'm the man, I'm the franchise, yeah. I ain't got Elizabeth, but I got Francine, dig it? No, I feel bad if he did say it. I'll go for Taz.
Yeah.
Is that you as well?
Is that Hurricane?
No, that's Steve Corino.
Looks like Hurricane.
At least it's one I've heard of.
What's his name?
Steve Corino.
C-O-R-I-N-O,
indeed, yes. You fucked up. FTW on his wrist tape. Referee's got coronavirus. He was coughing up.
He looks scared of Taz.
I would be surprised in 1999 if there was anyone in professional wrestling that wasn't scared of Taz.
Yeah, this is when he was a badass.
But... Yeah, big time. Simple as that. He sounds so scared.
He does.
He broke his appendix.
So he's going to quit from the match, isn't he?
How do you break your appendix? What's next? His fucking funny bone burst?
It's not even something that's used anymore, is it? He broke his redundant organ.
Yeah. He's just going to get choked out.
Yeah. Under 60 seconds.
Looking at the arena, I don't think there's thousands there. Is it Mikey Whipwreck?
He's actually getting squeakier. And more scared.
Yeah.
And more desperate. As he goes along, you think. Is it Whipwreck?
I know, he said underdog in ECW. It's the first one I come to other than Spike Dudley.
You're probably right, I think.
Are we going to see who it is? It's Sonny. It's Tammy Lynn Sims. So it's Chris Candido.
Chris Candido. He's sadly passed away, isn't he?
He has. Bless him. I think it was 2005. Jesus Christ, Tammy was fine. Sorry, had to say that. She's not wearing a lot.
No. She's not wearing more than she's wearing.
No. And even her gown / cape is see-through.
Yeah, well, I got rid of the 90s, though,
didn't it? To be fair, though, I'm going to stick with Taz, but... with Chris Candido instead of Steve Corino, I don't know.
This is the toughest one. Well, I know that second, but we had six there, didn't we? I'm still going Taz. Look how confident he is. I'm going Taz.
Yeah, fair play. That's exactly what I'm going for. But I mean, mate, this could be another good match as well.
Yeah, I think so.
Sonny loves it. Don't touch me.
2 minutes.
Is this another welcome back charm? We picked a great one, mate. We've got the returning to Cold Scorpio and Chris Candido. And we've also got to show your tits charm. Did you pick up on that one?
No, I just imagined it.
Do you know who that Steve Corino looks like to me now?
Like who?
He looks like an underweight Braden Walker.
I don't know who Braden Walker is, I've got to admit that.
He was in the WWE CW. He was also known as Chris Harris. He was America's Most Wanted with James Storm.
No. Harris, then I started thinking of the...
Wild Man, Chris Harris.
Yeah, I think.
The Pope.
Harris and the DOA,
wasn't it? Oh, the Harris brothers, yeah. Skull and 8-Ball.
Yeah.
They're also the Blue brothers, I think.
Yeah, Eli.
Yeah.
I don't know. The other Blue brother.
Yeah, and the other one, yeah. Other Blue and Eli Blue.
Yeah, Blue 2.
Yes. So this is going to be false count anywhere then.
I'm tempted by Candido now.
Too late. Yeah.
Yeah, bells rang, but they didn't hear it ring, but it was done.
We got done up by another ad break bit there.
Yeah.
Oh dear. Look at him, look, yeah, just go on. Just keep hitting me. Mate, if this is false count anyway, there's surely got to be a lot of weapon-based offense here.
You mean a lot of drinking, you mean?
Yes. Because not only that, you've also got Sonny and Steve Corino out there as managerial base for Candido.
Yeah.
Or Body Donna Skip. I'm just drinking along anyway. It's just, you know, you have to do them if these things happen.
Yeah, I'm not going to count that as a weapon shot. I'm going to wait for a proper into a weapon or through a weapon or hit by a weapon.
So with weapon shots, it can't be going into the stairs or the barricade. It has to be barricade or stairs into the wrestler.
Yeah, or through a table obviously counts.
Yeah, obviously. Yeah, you get through a table.
Different.
Oh hell yeah! But like that doesn't count.
No, I wouldn't say so.
Tails getting thrown into the barricade outside in the crowd.
Yeah.
Oh, is it? Oh, dirtbag wedgie.
Wedgie.
Now that is a ginger kid. Well, I thought my hair was ginger. Jesus. Bright orange. Look at it. Jesus, two of them. There he is, another one. We're all over the world. They kicked off his debut perfectly.
Yeah, that was good. I went back about half a year before I started watching it, but that's all. So you go back and see the tape before we started watching it. Rumble was when I went to Cactus Jack Triple H, one of my favourites all the time.
Yeah.
Taz was the beast on his debut, and then I saw something earlier actually today. He said something like that. He knew that he was screwed when the crowd started really chanting and cheering for him when he came out.
Yeah.
Like hoping that. Don't cheer me that. I just think I'm not going to like this.
ECW guy.
Which is ridiculous, isn't it?
Yeah, I think the problem they had was that Taz turned up, and then when the invasion angle kicked off, they wanted WCW to be the guys that were seen as, you know, better than ECW. But the problem is they had more ECW main eventers than they did WCW. So it made the ECW ones look even worse because they had to look second rate to people that, you know, weren't really all that in WCW, like Chronic and Sean Stasiak and, you know.
So they were third rate even before the ECW brand became the third rate brand in about 2006.
I mean, in terms of bona fide main eventers that came over for the invasion angle, who did you have really other than Booker T? Legit main eventers that didn't trade over, like Defect. And then the ECW main eventers, Tommy Dreamer, Just Incredible, Taz, Rob Van Dam, Dudley Boys, Raven. Every damn near one of them was a main eventer. World champion caliber. But they had to be worse than the WCW guys because they had to look better even though they weren't better. But in WWE's eyes, they had to be.
King always hated ECW, didn't he? And he was a big name in WWE, wasn't he?
You know, at some point, hopefully, if we do this, we can pick a date next time we do it. Hopefully, we'll find out the one where Jerry the King Lawler actually invades ECW.
That's good.
That would be a good episode to watch. Good slam. Where's he going? No, oh, we're back in the ring. The advert thing was a bit of a shame, but...
The size of Taz's thighs.
Oh, Yeah, he's a good two-thirds of the ring away, but Ed Bart, that was a good one.
Well, he used the full length of his body to reach him.
Yeah, he was going for an elbow drop, but his elbow probably wouldn't reach, so, you know.
Yeah.
I'll nut him.
Stop that. I'm going to use me head here.
No, when I said use your head, I didn't mean literally, you dumbo.
Come on, Candido.
Hit it. Chris Candido. Oh, he's got him done, mate. He's done.
I should have stayed there, shouldn't he?
Mate, if Brock Lesnar is the mayor of Suplex City, this guy is the architect.
Mate, Stein is in there as well, and he was in Suplex City.
Steiner, Angle, Taz.
Angle, yeah.
I mean,
Benoit.
The human suplex machine. You don't get called that. Oh, if you're not going to be good at them. Yeah, exactly that.
One
more time.
He only does the German now, doesn't he?
Yeah, it's gone like, yeah. He sometimes does a vertical.
He's fixated on the Führer.
Oh, look at that. He's done him.
What?
Nice. Ref, double count. Is that not a double count? Both shoulders were down. No? WWE ref would have counted all their shoulders down there, wouldn't they?
I really don't want to get one wrong. Honestly, yeah, I really want to get a string. It's the only time I can do it to get it, so I don't want to get one wrong.
Either. No, it's fair enough. Fair enough.
When it's gone, it's gone.
Oh, Jesus Christ, the referee nearly got done. Yeah.
We may have missed nobody. Oh my God! Here, well, I might have done it, but there you go.
No, I've not heard any.
You're better at the audio stuff. Yeah, keep track of that better than I will. I'm more of a visual kind of person.
Referee's like, thumb to the eyes.
CCW, mate, calm down.
Oh, mate, you would. Oh. CCW went a bit.
There's no disqualification in any of
this,
is there?
Well, this is one of them, mate. There's another one called CZW or CZW.
Yeah, I've seen that before. Well, not the show, but I've seen the letters. I know all the letters.
That's the one Moxley came through.
Moxley. What does that stand for?
Combat Zone Wrestling.
Combat Zone. I'm trying to think what the Z would be.
He's going to get him with another suplex, bro.
Yeah, this is hopefully... Oh, a Taz suplex off the top.
Yeah, mate. Over the top. See ya.
Just a good-looking plex.
It is literally a really good... Hang on. Oh, whoa, whoa, whoa. Does that count as manager interference? I think it does.
Did she touch him?
She's given Candido something.
She's touched him at least.
He's got Nux. Here. That's a weapon shot. One, two, oh! Yeah.
Come on, Taz.
In it, you don't
win.
Taz
misses the finish. As soon as he comes to the ring, brandishes a weapon over his head, goes underneath the prison chair. Taz mission, one, two.
With a Taz mission.
Yeah, gonna pin him to the mat.
Hold up.
Awkwardly.
Is he doing a Dudley impression? He is.
Get your drinks ready. You don't bring out a table without it being used, yeah.
No, mate, not an ECW, mate.
Doesn't happen.
They ain't got a lot of money, mate. If they bought the table, mate, that shit's getting broken. Is he gonna go for a belly the billy over the top sort of suplex?
And get reversed with a Taz flex through.
It's looking like it.
I'm hoping Taz does a Taz flex and wins. Great match though.
Oh, that's another good match. We picked a right good one here, mate.
We did. April 10th, 21 years ago. Fantastic.
This is it. 21 no years one. Ago. There it is. Oh, look. Not even. A, yeah, go on through the table. Oh, Joey just said, oh my God. Four.
Oh, and I think Kaz went to the table more than he did.
Four goes on the beer. Oh my God. Well, he's dead. He's done him. Taz.
I'm very happy. I haven't lost
about
yet.
Yeah, no, we're still 100%. What happened? Is he's actually... His neck's rear... He's looking screwed.
Yeah, he just can't carry on, can he? I'll pull myself another one, because I've run out. Bloody hell, Sonny. Give the guys a break.
Yeah, it's never, even though it was 21 years ago, still not nice to see if this was actually something that really did screw him up for a while.
Right, you know if it did?
Because he'd had a broken neck by this point.
Oh, I see, so it's kind of like a Daniel Bryan case where you can serve the rim, even when he's resting, I think.
Yeah, you know, you get certain injuries, you're a bit more cautious, but then back then... It's not like you had health and safety people everywhere, and you know, even then, no. This is ECW.
Yeah, they're not quite on the ball as they are now.
This is all that damn Steve Corino's fault.
He was the one that
if he had held the laces out like he was supposed to, Candido would never have lost that match. It's an Ace Ventura reference.
Yeah. He came out and he quivered.
He didn't get it.
Didn't he? That was a very necky landing, but I mean, that's
he did, yeah. He landed on his head as he went through the table. Not the best way to go through a table.
No.
Literally.
Yeah,
literally head first.
Yeah, if they went to the spot, you can imagine they still didn't want it to look so bottom of the table breaking like this.
Are they saying fuck you, Taz? Oh, here we go. Oh. Okay, so.
Yeah, you bastard.
There's just no need for it.
You still got the wearable to tap, at least. His head's not purple, isn't it? That head is purple.
Taz just does not care. Survive if I let you. That was a banging episode of ECW Hardcore TV.
Is that all done, is it?
Yeah, dude, yeah. No, it's only a small one. It's only because it keeps the videos to an hour, so it was done pretty well.
Yeah, 49:34 on my clock, yeah, fair enough, yeah. Two really good matches. It'd be nice if NXT follows that formula now, but the main brands don't, do they?
Well, we can always do that as well. We can always look back at some old NXT ones from like 2012 and 13 that we wouldn't have seen.
I mean, obviously, eventually we have to delve into the ones we've seen before. We still enjoy them and do other rules for them. I mean, I don't know if we missed anything out there, but what was on?
No, but I thought that was good. I enjoyed it. I thought that was a good episode. As I say, if that was on when I was a kid in this country, I'd watch that.
It's just brilliant being able to, because I don't do it on my own back and delve into these kind of shows of ECW and WCW. So it's nice to, obviously I know most of the wrestlers in them, but
yes.
It's nice to go into them and watch them, isn't it? It's brilliant.
Yeah, and you know, that's it, the first one. So it was 2-2, so I got fortunate there, so it's still 0-0. It will be 1-5. I got fortunate there.
I'm undefeated, obviously, and I know you are as well. But it's nice to not have one loss yet on the record, isn't it?
No, and I second-guessed myself, and I changed over when I found out it was a title match.
Fair play to you, sir. Nice for you to be in the same bracket as me without any losses.
That's it. So next time, whenever we film, we'll do the date accordingly as well. I don't know if it'll be ECW Hardcore TV that we watch next time. There's so many on there that sort of fill the time up, from AWA, SMW, Mid-Atlantic. There's loads. WCW Saturday Night. Even some old Sunday Night Heats, you know, watch everything. But until then, that was fun. Gonna take care, everyone. I want to say, you know, everyone be safe. Horrible situation going on. Any last thoughts there, Grogo?
Well, just that I've enjoyed this thoroughly, just in the sense that, the weeks before this, I've been just struggling a lot to find something to entertain myself, and this has been the most entertaining day I've had in this bad time, so I'm just happy I've done it, and just wish everyone the best. Fantastic, let's do it again, basically.
No, lovely. Well, everyone take care, and we'll see you soon. Farewell.
Be good, prosper.